given the fact that we wanted somebody really incredibly glamorous on the cover, why not somebody who was kind of slightly notorious as well?
Kate Moss, yes.
Who was very, very, very cool.
A very dramatic. And it is like some of the early Roxy Music covers, in a sense, in mood anyway.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And the music, you've got virtually all of the old Roxy Music musicians playing on this album.
Yeah, they play kind of a guest role, and it's great to have them in the studio on one or two of the tracks.
Yeah.
Phil Manzanera actually co-wrote one of the songs with me. Andy Mackay plays beautiful oboe on a couple of things.
Yeah.
And Bryan Eno even plays
keyboards
on a couple of songs. So it's great to have...
And Dave Gilmore.
But these are all people who have a history with me.
Got a lot of fairly grand friends, if I can put it that way. You move in exalted circles these days.
Slutty ones
too. But I'm just wondering, you know, as the miner's son from County Durham, how much of the miner's son is still there?
Oh, a hell of a lot, I think.
Yeah.
My dad never thought of himself as a miner. Not that it's a bad thing, because he was a ploughman. Basically, he was a farm labourer.
Right.
Who he used to be very proud of his ploughing prowess, and he had lots of medals for ploughing with horses, you know. Heavy horses were his thing. And in the Great Depression, the farm that he worked on kind of had no money, and he lived in a peasant cottage with no electricity.
Like almost every really famous rock star from this country of that age, you went to art college. I mean, everyone went to art college.
Well, yeah, I mean, by the time I got to university to study art, I was on the way to being a painter for the rest of my life. But music had been a great passion since about the age of 10.
I gather you saw Bill Haley at the age of 10.
I did, right? I won the tickets on a Radio Luxembourg, which is where we first heard American music, really, under the sheets, a little transistor. Yeah, I won tickets at the front row to see Bill Haley when I was 10, and it set me off on my giddy way into being an obsessive music fan, and that kind of ran in parallel with discovering the world of art, you know.
And do you think the art college background, the art background, had an impact on how Roxy sort of developed?
Oh, I think so, yeah, because I really wanted to do something different in music. And I think working under Richard Hamilton, I was very fortunate to have this great artist who was the leading light at Newcastle where I was a student. And he did this, one of the things he did was this wonderful collage, this pop collage, which was very influential, which I think I try to do something similar in music. Because the first efforts of Roxy were kind of dealing with different styles of music collaged together.
Yesterday, well, it seemed so cool when I walked you home, kissed goodnight. I said it's love, you said all right.
And it sounds to me, might be wrong, that you quite like to do another Roxy album in due course.
Maybe, yeah.
If you can.
You know, it seems to work very well that I do a lot of shows with Roxy on stage in the studio, working with, not a fixed group of people, all kinds of people come and go here.
Yeah.
So it's, I seem to have the best of both worlds at the minute.
In 2000, you're in an aircraft over Africa and a life-changing event took place.
I think it was one of the longest kind of plunges from a big plane. It was a 747. Somebody tried to crash it, basically. The captain and his co-pilot were amazing, and they fought off this guy and saved our lives, basically. So we were 7 seconds, I think, from hitting the ground. So that's pretty big plunge from 30,000 feet, wherever it is now.
Yeah. And was it literally sort of your life flashed in front of you, moment?
Just a little bit.
Yeah. Bryan Ferry, thank
you
very much.
Thinking about. Thank you.